Good evening, viewers. Welcome back to the Gear Up channel. Today, we are very lucky to have Brillian with us. Brillian is the head HR of Times Professional Learning. He's based out of Mumbai. And something awesome about Brillian is how he's managed to keep his interests alive, his personal interests in areas of public speaking, in areas of coaching, in areas of mentoring, and many more that I'm sure even I don't know. Brillian, welcome to this video.
Thank you. Good day to all, and thank you, Naga, for inviting me for this wonderful session.
Thank you, Brillian. Welcome once again. So those of you who might have visited his LinkedIn profile would find the three letters there saying DTM. So I was wondering what it was, and I asked him what it is. Now, DTM stands for Distinguished Toastmasters, and that's an awesome title to get, a credential awarded by Toastmasters globally for those who completed the entire path successfully. And this is indeed awesome, and I think having a DTM on the show, I should stop talking and invite Brillian over to share his ideas with us. So before that, one of the things that's been happening over the last 3 or 4 years is that hiring managers across organizations are looking for individuals who also have a personal side to their life. By that, I mean individuals who have an interest, have a passion, right? They are okay with someone who, someone who plays guitar on the side, someone who, collects even different types of pebbles, but really has gone deep into that, because they believe that that kind of builds up a wholesome individual who is able to contribute much better in the organization. And who better other than Brillian to tell us how this has probably helped him in his career, and also his own career learnings being a leader in the HR field for quite a long time. Over to you, Brillian.
Thank you, Naga. That's a fantastic way to begin the journey. Yes, when there is passion, there is the ability of an individual to make sure that the work gets done. And that's one of the prime reasons why organizations look for people who can do something other than what normal people do, that is beyond their work profiles, which also indicates that they are capable and they have the ability to make sure that they can multitask. If you look at how work scenarios are changing today, it's important for us to juggle between multiple things at the same time. And being a part of Toastmasters, it has helped me manifold. To be very honest, communication is always considered to be the key to success. While we all know aspects of communication, there are certain fine nuances which normally we do not get to know or learn unless we start practicing it. By being a part of Toastmasters for the last 12 years now, I have realized that while I used to speak, I used to participate in debates while in college and school, there was something still missing. Today, at any given point of time, I know for sure there are a few things that I need to take care of. The most important being, what is it that I want to speak, the audience that I am looking for, and what is the message that I finally want to live with the audience. So yes, Toastmasters has been very helpful. As a program, Toastmasters has evolved over a period of, I would say, 90 plus years now. And that's amazing. A journey which I began 12 years ago, and with the new curriculum that has come in, life has transformed. The way in which it works is, it helps you sharpen your skills in thinking on your feet, which is impromptu speaking, extemporary speaking that we say about, which means collect your thoughts, prepare what you want to speak, and shoot. It's like your elevator pitch. It helps you sharpen that. It helps you become better as a communicator, because everything is timed. Time is a critical aspect at Toastmasters. And we learn how to manage to convey a message and be to the point at that given point of time. And most important is the feedback that we receive from peers and people around, which helps you become better. Naga, I'm sure we all have heard about this cliched statement that people don't leave organizations, but they leave managers. And the reason is, managers are fearful to give the right kind of feedback at the right time. And with Toastmasters, I've made it as a practice, be it my team, my peers, or people whom I'm advising, that I provide them with the right kind of feedback, and I encourage them to utilize it in their work at every point of time. So yes, while it's a self-paced, self-learning program at Toastmasters, elements that I have learned, I have been incorporating it at work, and it's been helpful. So balancing that act is something which I feel has given me a slight edge in my current role as head of HR for Times Professional Learning.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I think the three things that I really picked up from what you said were what do I want to say, how do I want to say, and what do I want to leave with the audience. Brilliant stuff. Thank you. Brilliant. Any other thoughts from your own career in terms of things that seem to work to become a successful professional?
You know, my career contour, if you look at it, it's gone into different trajectories, and finally I am in here in HR. So I began my journey as an ambitious engineer looking forward to work in a software organization, but those days things did not work out and I ended up taking a job as a technical trainer teaching. And those days, you know how difficult it was living in a small town. We just did not have any means to go beyond. And there was a time when a colleague of mine, a friend of mine and I, we were discussing, and it hit us hard when we realized that the security guard standing at the building was earning more than the salaries of both of us put together. And that's when I started thinking and I said, okay, what I have will not take me where I want to, which means that I need to do something more than what I already have. And that's when I decided to pursue my post-graduation in computers, because computers was the in thing at that point of time. And irrespective of whether you were a mechanical engineer, civil engineer, or chemical engineer, you would end up being a software consultant or a software developer. So I decided to pursue that. And while doing it, a lot of life lessons really helped me survive that particular phase of my life. One was, it's important to prioritize. While yes, life keeps going on, you will have your job, you have to study, you have your family life, but until and unless you are able to prioritize, nothing will take you where you want to. So the biggest lesson I learned is you need to first sharpen your skills. As Stephen Covey has rightly said, sharpen your saw. So develop skill sets that will make you relevant, and not just make you relevant for now, but also for the future, which means that what is applicable today may not work for tomorrow. So you need to continue to sharpen the saw. And that's something which I realized was the most critical lesson for me very, very early in my stage of the career. The other part which I remember very clearly about it is never take things for granted. Most of us end up in a job and say, okay, now that I have a job, I can just relax. No, you need to give everything that you got 100% each time, every time. You may never find a job, I would not say never, you may not really find a job that is to your liking, but if you get into any job, make sure that you give 100% and people start admiring you for that. And then slowly you can demand, I would say, a portion of what you would like. So these are some of the lessons which I feel in the early part of my career have helped me stick to where I am. And the third most important lesson is we are all afraid of failures. We all know that, sorry to say this, but in Indian culture, a failure is always shunned and looked down upon. So people are very afraid to fail and they take failures to their heart. But one thing that kept me moving is a wonderful quote by Henry Ford, which goes, failure is only an opportunity to begin again, this time more intelligently, which captures the essence of how humans should really live life, be it your personal or professional. It's most important to take lessons and improve on it, work on it, because if we keep doing the things the same way, we'll get the same results. So I think these are the three lessons which every person would prefer to stick to, and life has given me those lessons early in my career.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Brilliant. With the lockdown situation, how do you see online learning you know, picking up after this, your own insights into, or rather, can I say foresight into it?
So, you know, it just take a blink of an eye to change. And that's what actually happened to all of us. Exactly about 1.5 months ago, 45 days ago, we would have never imagined that life would change for all of us. People were skeptical. In fact, early days, we were wondering, will it work? Will it not work? But reality is, everything is now online. Technology is the only way that we will go forward. I was very apprehensive when people said, oh, now everyone has to work from home. What happens to productivity? How do I monitor it? The same happened for learning. I was wondering, my son, he's in fourth grade and he has a very deferred kind of a start. His classes was supposed to start in April. Then he gets a break in May and then again it restarts in June so that the students don't feel that there is a huge gap between vacation. And I was wondering, how will they survive when there is a complete lockdown? And to my surprise, the school decided to go online. And trust me, you know, I would like to share this here when I'm reflecting on this. The students are teaching teachers, because most of the teachers have never been online. I keep hearing my son's classmates talking and telling the teacher, oh, teacher, you just go here and do this. You will be able to do it. Please log out and log in so that you can do this. And it's so amazing. The way in which life has changed post-COVID is online is the way to be. While the human touch is something which we all will miss, but online learning is the way forward. Even organizing institutions who were wary to go online with their curriculum for the fear of, you know, letting go of proprietary content, have today realized that yes, unless they change and accommodate to the needs, they will not be able to survive. And online learning has a long way to go. Personally, I have also taken up additional course right now as we are speaking. I am undergoing a course which I have been longing to do for a long time, which is finance for HR professionals. You know, we don't get time, but now that I am at home, I save about 4 hours of travel. I can invest that time in studying this, and it comes to me online. I can read, study at my own pace, and it helps me. So online, the way forward for sure.
Awesome. And with that, we end this first interaction with you. Brilliant. Looking forward to having you with us in many, many more future episodes and you know, helping the young professional and the student community in HR take the next leap. Thank you so much. Good night. Stay home. Stay safe.
Thank you. Thank you, Naga. Thanks for this. I would also like to say, stay home, stay protected, stay at home.
Thank you. Bye.